putting trial, and also doing subcontract water jets at this end. These machines are used for both testing and production, and doing work for other companies. This is one of the first machines they made, which is 8 years old and still going strong. In the production side of the factory, where they're just finishing a large BP machine. Very heavy frame for the reciprocator with a rack and pinion and linear bearings. The construction is either stainless steel or I think galvanised. Connections on one end for easy setup and installation. The rack is upside down to help keep it clean.
Yes. Yeah, we need a
chiller. Use a rack system and a double linear bearing. Here's a control unit. This is an industrial PC. This machine will take 2 weeks to install and 1 week to test. This jig is used for the modular construction. A module machine with 3 modules, 2 meters wide, so it can be easily extended in the future and easy to transport. Part of the extraction system which keeps the abrasive in suspension. There's a friction hose going to the machine. This is the older machine, and the newer one in the background is 1.5 years old. Crowder's air sludge extraction, which has a diaphragm pumped in the bottom of this container and pumped it into a bag. We're now in the training area and also their showroom. Although they sold their Sharon machine and need to replace it. Here's the pump unit, this is the 50 horsepower. And there's the intensifier.
It has less stroke,
which is
so you have more
easy to maintain.
Than the
slower cycling, so less wear.
The hydraulic system.
Testing and technical support at that end. The production side. It's the actual doing cutting trials, and also doing subcontract water jet at this end. Across the road are the offices.